What's up, it's your boy Dragon, and basically in today's video I'm going to break down how to make easy 3D text like this. Let's get straight to it. First thing you want to do is go to File, then you want to go to New, and you just want to hit 1500 by 500. After you do this right here, you want to hit G on your keyboard, and you kind of just want to go to your Paint Bucket tool, and your background, just make sure it's black. No matter how you get it black, just make sure it's black. Next thing you want to do is get a 2K background. I will link a few images in the comment section and description, but I simply just got this from over here, and what I did was Control C. I went over and then hit Control V. So you can have it on normal for now, but I'm gonna show you guys the actual setting that I do when I get the text in here. So just have it kind of like this. I'm gonna have mine about right here, and I'm gonna let that sit. So next thing I'm gonna do is go over in Cinema 4D. So I'm gonna go to File and then Open, and I'm gonna open the Lightroom in here. And the other Lightroom I'm gonna put in the comment section. I'm gonna put the one you can purchase, and I'm gonna put the one that like is a free Lightroom, and you can just do all that stuff. So yeah. All right. So we in Cinema 4D. Basically, what I'm gonna do is just change the text like so, and I'm gonna just name it Scrap. All right. So now that I do this, this is the font that I'm gonna be using right here. It's that simple to change it. Actually, I'm gonna do it lowercase like I did on the first one though. Alright, so now that you got it how you want it, you just want to go up here, click on that to render it, and you just want to let it play all the way out. Now, once this, alright, so next thing I'm going to do with the text is just turn the depth all the way down, now that you rendered the first one, and you just want to have it kind of flat. So I just go up here, put the zero if I really just want to be like that, and make sure it's just flat, you feel me? So, now that we have this, what we can do is we can render this again, back in Photoshop, just File, Open, and then you want to hold Control, and you can just click on both of these, get both of them. All right, so you want to hit Control C on this, go over here, hit Control V, hit Control C over here, go over here, hit Control V. So I'm gonna make sure everything is set up right, so those in the same spot. And what I'm gonna do is basically bring over this color correction, and I got this color correction from Izondo's pack. If you need that, I'm gonna just put in the description. So yeah, I'm just set this up, and I'll be back with you guys. Put these on soft light, the background, put that on soft light first. Then you just want to hold Control with these and just kind of bring it in. Like, you can put it anywhere, it really doesn't matter. But I'm gonna just put mine right here, I'm gonna center it. So, you put these back on normal now, and I'm gonna show you guys what to do. So, we're gonna actually get like the background inside the text, and I'm gonna show you guys. So, put these on soft light. And what you want to do is create a new layer in the middle, go to your brush tool, and you can just pick any color now. What color you pick, it does not matter. So I'm gonna just pick this color. What I'm gonna do is just kind of click around it like that. And what it's gonna do is make the background go out. That's what the effect does. We can just lower the opacity on that like so, and have it kind of like this. All right, so now what you wanna do is, you can hit Control S to save it, but what I'm gonna do is hit Control C on this layer, then go over here, hit Control V. I'm gonna create a clipping mask inside this first layer. And next, you already see the effect is taking place, like the cool text effect. So yeah, but basically with this, you can keep it on soft light if you want to. I'm gonna turn the opacity up while it's inside of the text. And with the actual text, I'm gonna show you guys what I'm gonna do with it. So what I'll do with the text is, you can do like subtract. I'm just showing you different stuff you can do. You can do subtract. I think I did, let me see. Yeah, I did color burn. Color burn is another good one. So that's like the effect you see everybody using. Well, it just look like it's inside the text or whatever. Look real cool. But yeah, you can do color burn, and I'm probably gonna end up doing that one. Now when I do this, sometimes I even hit Control U on the text. I go to colorize, and I kind of mess with those settings. Also, you can turn the saturation down in it. When you desaturate it, it's messing with the color a lot, but it still makes it look kind of cool. So if you even want to mess with that, you can hit colorize. Kind of change up colors inside, and yeah, it's pretty cool effect to do. So you can turn your lightings down or whatever. I'm gonna keep my lighting normal though, so I'm gonna just hit okay after that. So the back text is pretty simple. Also, you can just go to colorize on here and mess with the hue and stuff. But yeah, for the bottom text, you can just hit Control U on this and mess with your hue and stuff. You gotta hit colorize, and yeah, you can just mess with your hue. You can turn your saturation up. You can turn saturation down and still mess with it. But yeah, it's a pretty cool effect to do, and it's pretty simple. It doesn't take a long tutorial to explain how to do the actual effect, but it's just pretty simple to do. But if you want to go more into detail with it, like it's a lot of different ways you can do it. Like I can make a brush up here, and what I can do is I can click inside this text like so, just click around it. And when I'm clicking around it, what I can do is select pixels, hit Control J on this right here, and I can actually bring it back down here, create a clip mask on that, and you can even mess with the background like a lot more by doing something like that. But it's just different ways you can do it. You just have to mess with it a lot, and like I said, it's a lot of different ways you can mess with it. So even if you want to just do something simple like that, you can create another layer on top, go around it again like I just showed you guys, and just click on different spots. And what you can do is you can click on luminosity and you can lower the opacity on this. But with some settings, it'll like desaturate certain spots and stuff like that, so you can just mess with it. I just mess with all the settings in my opinion though, so like do something like that, just cool little effects you can do with the text. But yeah, for like the background, I know one thing I actually did was I hit Control J, had a layer down here that was on normal, and I actually changed the blend option on this layer also. So let me see which one I did. See, like this right here, this pretty cool hard mix. Can lower the opacity like that on here. And then you can have the text on the background. Well, I'm gonna lower it a little bit more. Kind of like that, yeah. But yeah, you can have the text on the background, and you can set this to hard light. And when you set this to hard light, you can have one in the front that's on normal and lower the opacity even more on this. And you can make the text even better. You can just go on with effects and stuff like that while you're doing the text. So yeah, that's pretty much how you make cool 3D text in Photoshop. And if you want an even more in-depth tutorial, just let me know. But I'm gonna show you guys how to make a glow at the end also. So you just hold shift and then click on the top layer by holding shift. Then you want to hit Control E, hit Control J after that, go to filter, and then you want to go to blur and Gaussian blur. You want to set your radius kind of on something like this. After you do it, you just want to set it to lighter color, and you can lower the opacity. This right here will make your 3D text glow, and you can even do this on thumbnails, banners, or anything. It works on everything, and you can mess with all the settings and stuff like this with the Gaussian blur, because it makes it look like kind of cool. I think I like lighting the best though, but yeah, it's all type of different settings you can do with this. If you guys enjoyed the tutorial, make sure you drop a like, subscribe, and I will appreciate that. Peace out.